Hello ladies and gentlemen, how do you do? Welcome to the edition of program users. Guys, for today we're going to look at the simplest recycler view possible. Okay, we shall look at the simplest ever recycler view. What I mean by this one is that actually what we're just going to be displaying images and text this way. We're not going to handle the onclick events. We're not going to display them in cards, of course. It shall just be images and text. We shall just arrange them in our bare layout. Okay, the main purpose of this tutorial, guys, is to introduce us to a recycler view, some of the recycler view terms like the view holder, pattern, okay, things like those ones. So guys, welcome, we'll get started. So guys, first jump to Android Studio and then right here, create a project, type the project name right there. Then next, my minimum SDK shall be API 15. Go to next. Right here I'm using the blank activity. You can choose it. It comes of course already with the toolbar, okay, so you can choose it, or if you don't want it, you can also just take the empty layout, okay. So that's it. Then click next and then click finish. I've already created mine right here. So the very first thing that I'll require us to do, I'll want us to set up some of the things that we're going to need. Come to a build.gradle right here and then just make sure that you have this particular library here, okay. Remember, recycler view is one of the components that come with the material design, so we have to add you can add this particular one, com.android.support.design23.2. This is my version, so it depends on the version that you have, but please make sure that you add it. So once we've done that one, the next thing that we shall need some images that we shall want to display in our recycler view, okay. Actually, remember, a recycler view, we have so many tutorials about this view, but now recycler view actually is much superior to list view in terms of performance and capabilities. So we want to start today. Now the first thing that we just want to display images and text. So just come right here, add your images. These are my images. The next thing for your layout, now we shall prepare a model, okay. Now you can see this is my model. It's just one image view right here and then two text views, okay. Actually the model is just the way a single row shall look when we are displaying them in our recycler view. So please make sure that you prepare your model. You can see this is my full XML right here, okay. So it's just one image view and of course two text views. So once we've done that one, the next thing, we shall come and prepare our classes. So come right here, we shall need a couple of classes. Now remember, by the way, the recycler view uses the view holder pattern, whereby, for instance, those particular views that we've displayed right here in the model, we shall have a simple class that shall be holding them. So let's create that class. I'll just call it something simple like my holder, okay. You can see so far it's an empty class. Let's also come and add another class, my adapter. So we shall have, in this case, we shall have a total of three public classes: main activity, my holder, and my adapter right here. Now let's get started with my holder. My holder, just as I said, its role is very simple for us. It shall need to hold for us a couple of views, the views that we want to display. So the first thing that we shall do, come right here and make sure extends recycler view dot view holder, okay. We're going to inherit from the recycler view dot view holder class. So come right here. No, we're not going to implement anything. We won't handle the click events for today. Now this one shall require us to create a matching constructor, and right here we have our constructor. Inside, when somebody instantiates this particular class, he shall be required to pass a view object, okay. Now what are the views that you shall want to display first? The first one is image view. So we shall come right here, image view. I'll call mine img. The second one shall be the text view. first text view, I'll call mine name txt, and then lastly we shall also require another text view. For me, I'll call mine pose txt. Okay, now these things, of course, we've said that a view shall be passed right here. Now what we're going to do, first image view img equal to find view by id. Okay, obviously we can't just find it directly, so we shall be use the view that shall be passed right here. So item view dot find view by id, then right there we shall pass r dot id, then dot image view. Now guys, take note that this id it's right here inside our model. I specify, now you can see, for instance, this is my id, then this is the id for the first text view, and then the id for the next text view. So don't be surprised by that. Then by this one we come right here and we cast it. Now we're going to do the same for the other text boxes. So the first one, of course, shall be the name txt. It shall be a text view, and right here its id shall be name txt. This one, its id shall be pose txt. It shall be a text view, and of course it's the pose txt. So that's it. That's the only thing you're going to do inside our view holder, inside our holder class. Now you can see it's very simple. It's just, its role is just to hold for us these particular views. Okay, so that's it. That's our view holder, my holder class. I'll just close it. Now we shall come to my adapter. So my adapter, actually it is here that we shall be converting, that we shall be displaying the particular views to our recycler view. Okay, remember what we want to do, we shall want that we shall be recycling these particular views, so that instead of every time instantiating a new view for each particular row, we shall just be reusing them. So we shall come right here. The first thing, our my adapter class is going to inherit from the recycler view dot adapter. Okay, so come right here and say extends recycler view. Dot adapter. Now it's a generic, we pass here our my holder class that we had already specified. Then we implement the methods it wants us to. You can see on create view holder, then on bind view holder, then get item count. So let's come, the first thing that we're going to do, let's come and have some fields right here. The first field is the context. Now these are the fields that shall be passed via our constructor. Okay, this is my adapter constructor. So context I'll have right here string. The first one, of course, I'll call it players or names. Then I'll have another array of string, this one I'll call positions. Then lastly we shall have images. I'll just come right here, images. So we're going to create our constructor, public my adapter. Inside our constructor, of course, just as I said, we shall pass the context. After the context, we shall need to pass a string array that shall contain for us players. Then we shall also need to pass a string array to hold for us the positions. And then lastly, we shall need an integer that's going to hold for us our images, image IDs. Now that's it. So of course we come right here and assign them this dot c equal to ctx. Then this dot players equal to players. This dot positions equal to positions, and lastly the images. So remember, this data shall be passed dynamically from our main activity. Does it? No, once they are passed through our constructor, we shall store them in these particular fields so that we can use them. Okay, then that brings us to our view holder, our own create view holder method. Now you can see right here, this method we're going to return my holder object. So let's come right here and say view. Let's create a view object to hold for us a view from our XML. So I've imported that one. Then we're going to inflate from our XML to our Java object. So it shall come right here, layout inflator dot from. You can see we need to pass the context. Now to get our context, we're just going to call parent dot get context. This one shall give us the context for the calling class. Then after our context, once we have that particular context, now we can just inflate. Then we pass our layout dot layout dot model. Okay, remember the model is just how a single row shall look for us. So that's it. We have our view right there. Then we are going to create a my holder object equal to new my holder. And then of course we need to pass that particular view object inside our my holder constructor. Then we return that particular holder object. That's it. Now we bind our view holder. This is where we shall be binding our views to our data. Okay, remember right here we are concerned about inflating our views from our XML of course to our Java object. Now once we have our view, we have to bind data to it, and that's what we're going to do right here. So to do that one, we just call holder.set. Now first get, for instance, the view, the particular view that we want. Let's start with the image equal to dot set image dot image dot set image resource. Then right there we pass, remember we shall be getting an array of images, then we just pass the position so that we get that particular image. Then holder dot name txt, then we set its text property. We shall be getting an array containing names or players. We just pass the position, and we do the same for our positions. So right here, this is position txt, then we replace this one with positions. So guys, that's it. That's how we are going to bind our data. And of course, if we want to, this method should return for us the total number of items. We shall just call the size of players or the length of players. That shall give us the total number. Now guys, that's it. That's our adapter. It's that simple. We have our adapter right now. We also have our holder. The next thing is just to come right here to our main activity. Remember, right here, these have been auto-generated for us. This is for the toolbar, and of course, this is our floating action button. Okay, now what we want to do, the first thing, we're going to come right here. We need a recycler view in our layout. So let's come right here. You can see right here my activity main layout. This is like the container layout for me. Now inside it I include the content main. Okay, the content main is where now we shall be adding our views, so we just include it right here. So actually mostly you shall be dealing with our content main right here. So you can see it's a relative layout right here, our root node right there. And then I've just added a recycler view. So this is my recycler view. You can see it right here. Okay. Here is my recycler view. I've given it an ID of my recycler. It's that simple. You can just type it and add it right there. It's a simple one. So once we have it right there, we're now going to instantiate, get our recycler view. Okay. And to do that one is very simple. You just come right here, recycler view. Mine I'll just call RV equal to find view by ID. Then we reference it from our XML file. So equal to my recycler. And of course, we just need to cast it to recycler view. So guys, this is giving us now our recycler view object. Once we have it. Unlike list view, with the recycler view, we have to set the layout. Okay, we have to set the layout. So just come right here and say RV set layout. We have to set the layout manager. So I come right here and say RV set layout manager. Then we're just going to use the most basic. A layout manager, which is our linear layout. So we just pass its instance right there, and of course we pass the context. So that's it. That shall set for us. Set layout. Then once we've done that one, the layout manager shall be responsible for dealing with the layout of our recycler view. Remember, we can also have the staggered grid layout manager. Can also have, of course, the grid layout. So for us today, we are just using the most basic one, the linear layout. The next thing, we need to create our adapter. So for that one, we're just going to say we called it my adapter. So I'm just going to instantiate it equal to new my adapter. And remember, for our adapter, we need to pass first the context, then of course the players. We've not included the players, so the first thing we need to come right here and add our data source, which for us will just be simple arrays. So I'll type them very fast, and here I have my data. Now you can see first it's just an array of players, then positions right here, and then images. Given that we're using arrays, please just make sure that it's the same number, okay? That the length or the size of your arrays are the same. Like for me, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. All of them should be that way. Remember, I had added my images right here, so you can also add your images. So that's it. The first thing, we come right here, we add our players. And then we add the positions, and then of course we add our images. We're adding them in the order in which we specified in our my adapter class. You can see context, players, positions, and of course lastly images. So that shall give us our adapter object. What we need is now to set that particular adapter to our recycler view object. So come and say RV set adapter, and then we pass that particular adapter. Adapter, and that's it. That's how we set our adapter. Guys, is that way? Now, what we simply do, we come run our project and run it in my BlueStacks. And guys, here is our simple recycler view. Can see right here images and text. Okay, so guys, that's it. Hope you've enjoyed the tutorial. Please, if you have liked the video, comment down below. You can also view our other upcoming recycler view tutorials and material design in general. Please, if you love the tutorial, please subscribe so that you continue receiving tutorials like these ones on a regular basis. Take care, I'll catch you in the next tutorial.